expert on the emoluments clause and how it applies, but I'll just say it this way. I have been a public official for most of the last 20 years. It is 20 years now. I was in two offices in state government, now in the United States Senate, and I've dealt with a lot of public officials. I have never seen, never worked with, or even observed from a distance, a public official who seems to be less observant of lines and rules and what not just what ethical rules are or what conflict of interest rules are, but whether or not there's even the perception of a conflict of interest or an ethical violation. It seems that every week that goes by, we're learning more, that's a silent affirmation. We're learning more and more about a business interest over here of the president or someone directly related to him or connected to him in a potential conflict with regard to policy over there. And that's why Robert Mueller's investigation, among many reasons, is absolutely critical that Robert Mueller come to a conclusion so that we have some certainty with regard to what happened precisely in the election, whether there was, in fact, a relationship between the Trump campaign and the Russian interference with the election. We would be a lot better off as a nation if the president said basically two things, right? In my judgment, you could say some other things too that would be helpful, but two things on the Russia question. Number one, that he accepts the definitive findings of 17 intelligence agencies that the Russians interfered in our election, number one, and number two, that it favored his campaign. What he should say as president is, I accept that, and the next thing he should say is, I'm gonna do everything I can. I'm gonna take every step necessary as president to stop this from ever happening again. And if Mr. Putin does this again, he's going to be sanctioned. We're going to hold him accountable. We're never going to allow Mr. Putin or the Russians or any adversary to do this again. But of course, President Trump has said none of that. He so far has been denying that it even happened. And he doesn't seem to be too concerned about them interfering in the 2018 election. And they will, and they are, unless we stop them from doing it. So maybe as Robert Mueller comes to decisions about the investigation of those questions, there may be, I hope, some light shed on these other questions about business interests and whether that is a conflict of interest or a violation of the emoluments clause. I don't know if he'll get to that precise conclusion, but I hope that his investigation will shed light on that, as well as the litigation that involves the emoluments clause. Okay.